welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Rejuvenation. In the last episode, we continued more of the story progress and discovered that Team Zim is now back again and now tormenting Golny Village, and even tried to frame me as the bad guy. Which, boy, these Golny people are just stupid. They barely have much of a brain. Not to be too offensive, though. By the way, like I mentioned before, I am now back at the front of Wispy Tower, like I told you all to do. Even though that's today's episode, you're all probably maybe training up some of your own Pokemon, trying to get things ready before you fight Team Zan. Which, really, you're going to need to. Anyway, before we go, I'm going to mention right now that today's episode is going to be a little short because I got to go somewhere in about a good few minutes, so we're going to have a in between 15 to 20 minute video today.
Oh heck, this thing is in the floor, wasn't here before. And I would know. I frequent this place a lot to search for treasure. Whenever they went down there, I want to see it because I'm nosy.
So, Wispy Tower has something that was hidden. And it wouldn't surprise me whatsoever if there is some Pokemon down this place. Let me double check my... Yeah, that's exactly why I'm going to be mad. Just in case. Which floor? I think I finally reached the end. Huh? Who's there? Let me guess. You're some Team Zen executive like Zeta?
Huh.
So you know who Zeta is. You must be the one of Satina's little friends, then. You fought Zeta in Anna's cave, right? That's right. I fought alongside my two friends to save another. But we failed back then. I won't let that happen this time. Ha! You mean Milia? Yeah, that was unfortunate. But her death won't stop us from achieving our end goal. She died in vain, a pointless death. You're truthfully awful. Her death hasn't stopped you, but I will.
You sure about that? Only the... Okay, Tuga. Luckily for me, I already got what I came for. But I can be a test dummy to see what it can do. Let's play a little game.
What was that?
This is going to be fun.
Oh! Foreshadowing roar, and even the way how it looked.
Aye! They got an entrance down. Aye! They got an entire lab down here. Down under the Wispy Tower. I was expecting like a closet or something. We had to deal with an entire base. I ain't ready for this one, dude.
Uh-oh.
What is this place? Aren't you like the owner of this tower or something? I thought you of all people would know where we are. My husband Cyrus was the owner. I have no knowledge of this place. Oh, weird. Wait, I know you.
What?
No, you don't. You're the troublemaker that frequently steals from the Pokemart in town. But not only that, you harass the local townsfolk for no apparent reason.
Heh, well, you.
They don't make it so easy to get agitated. But you don't have to worry about me anymore, Mana. Satina saved me from a mean old witch, and I turned over a new leaf. Is that so?
may need our assistance. Did you notice the icons on the top left? This means that you have a party members with you. Whenever these icons appear, this means you can engage in group talk. To activate group talk, press the A key on your keyboard. During group talk, your companions will have unique things to say depending on the room you're in. Try it out. So my Switch Pro controller, I press the X button.
Man, the people who own this lab don't clean up very well. I find it hard to believe the people here left their quarters like this. Time is to be blamed. Would you just cast a spell on me? No, I'm just speaking Calosian.
Calosian.
Oh, phew. And I thought I was gonna live 30 years as a Zigzagoon. You have a wild imagination, Mosley. Imagine I'm already cursed by a witch by Lugio from another world. It's true. I'm sure.
Huh, it's kind of interesting. It's kind of like a bit like, in Xenoblade Chronicles. Really, I shouldn't be a thief when you go up and steal stuff? Well, yeah, that right there was a bit of a reminder, folks, that you cannot use your... for a stealth rock. It's not the real point in me using stealth rock. Wow. It got all five. This is what I get for getting, I was about to say, does Beedrill have skill leap? By the way, since there's some grass around here, a lowland dagger. Oh, thank you. What the fuck happened to Dunsparce? worse. Is he supposed to be like a wrestler? Well, now I know what shiny Dunsparce looks like. Too bad it still kind of sucks. I mean, yes, it has Serene Grace. It has an incredible moon pool, but it is downright not even that good. Like, its stats are not that good. And its evolution, it's not until Gen 9, which yes, I know Gen 9 is already out, but I'm not gonna bother with it. Okay, I'm back again. I got myself into a fight without me too. I was actually just still looking for to see if there's any other new Pokemon in there, though it looks like that just might be all the Pokemon that are in with that are within that little area. Go for a swap. But at the cost of getting destroyed in the battle. Did me a huge favor by activating a Swiss whip. So basically, that Team Zen member just screwed himself. Wild Throwout does a good amount of damage, however, I have to wait until my opponent's turn ends. Low Sweep gets about 5 power less, but I can lower my opponent's. You know what? Wild bro. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, I am now back again. So remember in one of my tech, I was mentioning I was gonna try to find a easier and faster way of telling y'all what's within the area. Well, now is my chance. So, in the Forsaken Laboratory, there are 6 Pokemon that you can find here. However, I'm down to bit only 5 of these are available right now. First off, we have Alolan Diglett. I don't really recommend Alolan Diglett. It has the type of ground steel, but in my opinion, that just gives it more weaknesses. Let's see here. Week 2, Water, Grass, Ice. Okay, never mind. I just made a liar out of myself. It has the same. Wait a minute. I'm looking. Oh, there it is. Oh, I was looking at. I was looking at the wrong Pokemon. Alolan Diglett. Weakness to fighting, ground, fire, and water. So it swaps the ice type weakness for a fire type weakness. It swaps the grass weakness for a ground weakness. I would still say just go for normal Diglett. I don't recommend Alolan Diglett that much, but if you're of course looking for Alolan Diglett and it's your favorite, hey, now you know where it is. Up next is Dunsparce. I have already said what I wanted to say. He's not that great right now. Hopefully in Gen 9, he will get that evolution, even though that evolution is the worst of them all. Up next, of course, there's Geodude, Graveler, and Dugtrio. Oh man, it's just normal Dugtrio. Anyway, like I said, there are 6 Pokemon here, though I'm bound to bet that the 6th one is not available yet, at least. Who knows? I could be wrong, and you can find one. We'll just have to wait and see. Anyway, that is all the encounters in the Forsaken Laboratory. Wispy Tower also has encounters, but I haven't found any grass at all because of that hiker is in the way. I'll let this video go on a little longer though. Yeah, I know I say I'll make it like a in between 15 to 20 minutes, which the time run right now is 19 minutes in. But because of all that hickory bickory stuff I was doing with the Pokemon that are available thing, hey, I thought that was the faster thing, and to me that does feel a bit faster. Okay, turning off all encounters. Let's see. There's some water coming from here. Ooh, yeah, revive. I should also keep an eye out for any hidden items in here. Wait. It feels weird having party members with me, but they don't really do anything besides just okay, talk. There you go. Slandy will never be able to be bored. It's gonna remain weak for the rest of its life. It's gonna have a Pokédex entry that talks about Slandy. It's actually kind of dark. Like the females, they actually prevent the male population from evolving. That's just kind of dark.
What's this monster against us say?
Koopa, the Koopa, the mysterious Pokemon, is a being that can warp space with six rings it carries. With Koopa, we will be able to reach new dimensions and gather heights.
I don't really get it.
The people down here want to use Koopa's power to jump through dimensions. For what reason, I do not know.
You missed something, Narcy.
Narcy? What did I miss?
It says password unbound.
We should keep that in mind going forward then.
Okay, interesting. So we have a password called unbound. Can't really think of much of a reason, but might be important later on. Oh, so I can't go any further. Is this a healing machine? Wow. Trying to piss me off. Fractini. That's it. Dragon on dragon. Let's do this. Care, sir. You did the unspeakable. If you had Charizard in there, you would have pissed me off even more. Fudge you, breeders. Fudge you for not letting me have my gibble in early game. Anyway, that's gonna be it for today's episode. Next time on Pokemon Rejuvenation, we'll be exploring the rest of the Forsaken Laboratory. So, if you enjoyed today's episode, please share, like, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you all for the next episode. Have a nice day.